Howdy, ladies and gentlemen. Today we are going to take a glimpse at the concept of communicating sequential processes. It was first described by the famous British computer scientist Tony Hoare in 1978. CSP itself is a formal language for describing patterns of interaction in concurrent systems. Let's try to understand what does that mean. In mathematics, a formal language is normally defined by an alphabet and formation rules. For example, the language of propositional calculus could be defined as follows. The alphabet of this language is comprised of English letters with optional indexes and the following spatial symbols. Not negation and conjunction or disjunction implies if-then and grouping. The formation rules are that every English letter and every letter with an index is a formula. And if A and B are formulas, then so are not A, A or B, A and B, if A then B, and grouping A. Patterns of interaction are just different ways of describing interaction itself. These are the templates. The goal of the concurrent programming, not to confuse with parallel programming, is to model interaction of processes concurrently, such as, for example, multiple clients accessing a server, which could happen simultaneously or at different times. Now let's get back to the CSP. The basic idea of CSP consists of two main aspects, its synchronization and guard commands. Multiple concurrent processes are allowed to synchronize with each other by synchronizing their input and output. It happens as described on the next slide. Process A states that it is ready to output to process B specifically, and process B states that it is ready to input from process A specifically. If one of these happens without the other being true, the process is put on a wait queue until the other process is ready. Also, we need to know what a guarded command is. A guarded command is a normal command program statement preceded by a guard, which is a Boolean expression. The statement is only executed if the Boolean guard evaluates to true. The concept of guarded command was later further developed as well known today preconditions. Speaking about syntax, let's take a look at the comparison of CSP and ALGOL programming language. As you can see, there are not many differences. We do here initializations and then swap the assigned values. It is interesting how guard commands are represented. On the first line there is an alternative command, which today is known as disjunction. Square symbol means OR. On the second line we have guard commands, left part represents guards that are prerequisites, which if only satisfied, the right part is being executed. The third line is an example of just guards without commands. And on the fourth, we see commands syntax without guards. Here we see an example of synchronization. Process A outputs X to process B via exclamation mark and process B inputs a value via question mark from process A and assigns it to Y. There are three problems with CSP I'd like to cover in this video. Its explicit naming of communicating processes, absence of buffer and absence of any proof method. Explicit naming of concurrent processes is just complicated. For example, a minor mistake such as passing value types that do not correspond to each other leads to crash of both processes. Also, if output process refers terminated process, it is going to terminate too. Second issue, which is more a minor one, affects communication between processes. It does not assume any permanent storage, such as buffer, complicating the process of data transmission. Of course, buffer could be programmed via own implementation, but it additionally creates difficulties. The third is quoted by Tony Hoare. The most serious problem is that it fails to suggest any proof method to assist in the development and verification of correct programs. I'd like to add that CSP shifts the responsibility of correct termination of the program to programmer, as program termination cannot be proved. Nevertheless, CSP rocks and made significant breakthrough, especially in functional programming. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. See ya! Created using Powtoon.